Hello everyone, what's up? Welcome to a new quick edit video, this time with another hazy mountainscape image from the Dolomites in Italy. And on this shot I want to apply a very contrast rich style by making the mountain in the center a lot brighter while adding a lot of dark tones all around this mountain. For this shot I will be using Adobe Lightroom Classic and maybe later make use of Photoshop as well. But let's first take a look at the before and after images. So here we are in Lightroom Classic, then let's go to the Lens Correction tab first and activate those two settings. And before I go back to the top, I want to start in the Calibration tab this time and already adjust those colors a little bit. Usually I would do this at the end of the editing in Lightroom, but for this shot I had an easier time when I start with those settings here. So I want to boost the saturation of the blue tones first. This will make the yellow parts in the mountain a little stronger, as well as the blue parts in the sky, which I will reduce later in the HSL tab. Then I'm also dropping the green saturation all the way down. And then let's adjust the red saturation a bit. And then let's also drop its hue. Okay, as you can see, the colors are a little different now. Then let's go back to the top and change the camera profile to Adobe Landscape, just because this will help make those yellow tones in the center a little more interesting. For the white balance, I'm going with daylight, and then let's balance the exposure a little bit. As said in the intro, I want to have a lot of contrast and make it rather dark, so let's start by dropping the exposure. This already looks much better, but still we don't have much contrast going on here. Let's increase the highlights. And also we can increase the whites. And then let's drop the shadows. Alright, that starts to look really cool. Still, I want to add some overall contrast. Okay, nice. For the next step, I want to play around with the clarity a little bit. I think I add some clarity, since this works great on such mountainscapes. Also, I think I'm dropping the texture, just to make the shot look a little more hazy. And then finally, let's also drop the saturation just a little bit. Nice. Then let's also do some local adjustments. Here you can see I have applied one gradiated filter, which basically covers the left side of the image. In this area there isn't much interesting going on, so I want to darken it and thus bring the focus more to the center of the image. So let's just drop the exposure again. Okay, then next I have applied the radial filter, which I place over the center. And I want to make this area appear to be glowing. So for this reason, I'm increasing the blacks slightly. Also, I'm dropping the dehaze very carefully. And then I want to apply a warmer color to this area. I could increase the temperature, but in this case, I want to use the color setting, which is kind of hidden all the way down in the local adjustments. So let's click on that box here. And I want to go with a warm color, of course. And boost the saturation here. This looks really awesome. Then let's continue with the color grading. I'm starting in the HSL tab with the saturation. And right away I want to drop the blue saturation. And maybe even increase the yellow saturation a bit. Then let's switch to the luminance tab, and my goal here is to make the blue of the sky very dark. I even tried to make it black, but that doesn't work that well with the luminance settings, but I still can reduce it quite a bit. And this just looks so much better in my opinion. For this shot I'm not touching the split toning, instead let's go straight to the sharpening. And That's it for the Lightroom part. Now let's switch over to Photoshop to finish the editing. Alright, first I think I need to crop the image further. I don't like the very far right side of the image. I want to get rid of some of it. So let's crop it like this. Also, I think this dark area right there looks kind of strange. So since I don't have a problem with photo manipulation, I'm simply using the clone stamp tool to copy this cloud right here and fill this gap with some extra clouds. Just in case I mess something up, I'm duplicating this layer by pressing Ctrl J, pick up the clone stamp tool, and then let's adjust the brush size a little bit. Then by holding down the Alt key and clicking in this area, I'm copying this area, and I can simply brush it in down there. And let's continue with this until this spot is fixed. Okay, and that looks much better. Then next I want to make a few areas a little darker, especially those dark peaks here in the foreground and a few darker parts of the bright cliff in the center part. Since I want to specifically target certain luminance ranges, I'm using luminosity mask. And for this reason, let's duplicate this layer one more time here. Now for the luminosity masks, I'm using the TK panel plugin, which is just an easy way to create those masks. And then I want to specifically target the dark tones of the image. Here you can see everything that's brighter than 50% gray will be affected by everything I'm doing to it. Since I want to target those peaks in the foreground, this seems to be the perfect mask for it. So let's create a layer mask out of this luminosity mask, apply it like this, and then create a new layer and hold down the Alt key, click between those two layers to create a clipping layer, and switch the blending mode to overlay. Now I'm grabbing the brush tool. Here I think I reduce the opacity a bit further. Set the foreground color to black. And now very carefully make those peaks a little darker. Also, I want to touch the sky a little bit here. And this looks pretty nice. Now I'm merging everything by selecting all the layers and hitting Ctrl E. And finally, I want to check the Nick collection to see if there are any nice effects for this picture. Then first, let's go with the polarization effect. This will just help with those colors a little more by making the center more saturated, while also making the sky a little darker. Of course, I don't want to go overboard with the saturation here. So I think something like this looks pretty nice. I could even add some dreamy look to it using the Nick collection, but I think for this shot that would be too much. So at this point I want to stop the editing. I hope this was interesting and helpful. Of course, if you have any questions regarding the editing, then please let me know in the comments, and thank you very much for watching this video.